Good morning, friends. We will continue our chapter gravitation. So, as a revision, we'll see we saw Newton's universal law of gravitation, then the acceleration due to gravity on the Earth and other planets, and in the previous lecture, we saw the application or the practical applications in this world due to the downward force acting on the body, that is the weight, which causes the pressure on the surface of the earth. So to understand pressure, we first understood the concept of thrust. What is thrust? The force acting perpendicular to the surface is called thrust, and pressure is equal to force upon area. So you saw that every body in the universe which has got a mass will have a downward force called gravity, called weight, which exerts the pressure on the surface of the earth. So whether it is a solid, a liquid or a gas, they all have mass and they have got a force in the downward direction. And pressure is equal to force upon area. So a solid, liquid and gas will have pressure acting towards the surface of the earth or towards the center of the earth. But we also saw that gases and liquids are called fluids. What is the property of fluids? They can flow, means the molecules move in every direction. So in a liquid, the molecules go and collide with the walls of the container. So liquid also exerts pressure sideways on the walls of the container. And when it comes to a gas moves in all directions, even upwards. That is why we have got this gas cylinders at home, which is closed from all sides because it should hold the gas. The gas exerts pressure in all the directions. So this is the revision we have done so far. A little bit from the previous lecture, we had derived this formula here. Pressure P equal to H rho G. How did we derive rho? I hope you remember. I took an imaginary cylinder. Okay, in the water I considered an imaginary cylinder. I called this depth V, or I can even call the height H. This is the area at the bottom. So the derivation was the pressure equal to force into, force upon area, not into. Pressure was equal to force upon area, but the force is the downward weight. Force is the downward weight, W, and W equal to mg. Now this is the mass, so density equal to mass upon volume, so mass is equal to density into volume. Volume equal to area into height. So replace this in this formula, we got P is equal to F, that is W. W is mg. What is m? D into V, that is D into A into H, because V, volume is equal to area into height. So we got here m into D, density. This density, I use the letter rho, area A and H. Sorry, not this. M, mg, so mg is replaced by density, area, height, density, area, height into g, so this is our g, upon a, the a and a got cut, and we got p equal to h rho g. So pressure in a fluid depends upon three things: the height or the depth. So here we have got the depth. So now you have to understand, as you go deeper inside, the pressure keeps on increasing. You can try it out in a swimming pool. When you go deeper and deeper into a swimming pool, you will feel the pressure of the liquid upon you. It will not happen at a very low, less height, but when you go much deeper, so divers who dive into the ocean, into the seas, have got special diver suits. So the divers who dive into the oceans have got special diver suits to withstand the pressure. because as they go deeper, the pressure of the water increases. You will even see that animals that live at too much of depth, very deep inside the water, are usually flat because of the pressure. So nature has got its own design. Because the pressure increases with depth, you will find animals inside the water of different shapes and sizes depending upon which depth they live. Then we have rho, that is the density of the liquid. Here we have taken water, but rho is the density of the liquid and g is the acceleration due to gravity. So pressure at any point in the fluid is given by the formula P is equal to h rho g. H is the height or the depth, rho is the density of the liquid and g is acceleration due to gravity. Now remember this very well, the pressure acting, okay, the pressure. So this pressure is acting downwards. Now this force is acting downwards, force upon area gives pressure, so we show pressure increases with depth. Okay, now since we have understood pressure inside a liquid, inside a fluid, the next thing we need to see is a topic called buoyancy. Now what is buoyancy? Let us understand this. You can see in the diagram, we are holding a stone tied to a string. Okay, what is the force acting on this stone? So gravitational force is acting on the stone in the downward direction, and the gravitational force is nothing but the weight. So W equal to M into G. So you are holding the stone in air. Now the same stone is held in water. Will it feel lighter? Have you tried this? So the stone is first held in air, then with the help of a string it is held in water. Will it be lighter in water? Yes, you will observe that when you get on the swimming pool, if you have played with your friends in the swimming pool and tried to lift your friend, you will find that the friend feels lighter in water. So now what is happening here is there is a weight in the downward direction because of the gravitational attraction of the earth. Yes, which, so the weight is in the downward direction. So the stone is pulled downwards. Now the water exerts an upward force on the stone. Now why does the water do that? So you can see here, the weight of the stone in air was more, the weight of the stone in water is less. Means I'll write here, the weight of the stone in air was more than the weight of the stone in water. Now what has happened here which has reduced the gravitational force? So this upward force which is making the stone lighter is called buoyancy. So the definition is the upward force exerted by a fluid. Fluid means liquid or gas, both. The upward force exerted by a fluid on the object when it is fully or partially immersed in a fluid is known as upthrust or buoyant force. So buoyant force is the upward force. Okay, so we'll call it the upthrust U. I'll call it U. So this is W acting downwards, the weight, and this is upthrust U acting upward, which makes the stone lighter. Now let us see what is actually happening here. We saw that there is pressure at a depth, pressure at a depth in the liquid, which is given by the formula P is equal to h rho g. So as you go deeper, the pressure increases, right? So we know pressure equal to force upon area. So force is equal to pressure into area. So this pressure which the liquid has got at this level is acting on the area of the stone, and pressure into the area is the force in the upward direction. So what is upthrust again? It is the force exerted by a fluid. Every fluid, whether liquid or gas, exerts a force in the upward direction against gravity, which is called the upthrust. Now we know that on any body in a fluid, two forces are acting. One is the weight in the downward direction, one is the upthrust in the upward direction. So there can be three conditions. Which three conditions? Okay. Now we'll see which three conditions are formed by the W, that is the downward weight, and the upthrust, which is the upward force. But before that, let us think of one more example. We dipped a stone in water, it felt lighter. Now try an empty bottle, try to immerse an empty bottle in water. So the stone, when you put it in water, it felt lighter, but it sunk inside the water. Now when you try to put the bottle inside the bottle will not sink, the bottle will float. Okay, so the force again due to gravity of the earth acts on the bottle in the downward direction. So the bottle is naturally pulled downwards. If you put the bottle in air, it will fall down. But the water exerts an upward force on the bottle. Okay, so the bottle is pushed upwards. Now we have learnt already, we did, what is the weight because of gravitational acceleration. Okay, but in this case, I told you there are three cases possible. Look at this case. When the bottle is immersed, the upward force exerted by the water is greater than its weight, and therefore it rises up when released. So if you try to push the empty bottle inside the water, as soon as you release the bottle will pop out. Now if you want to keep the bottle completely immersed, the upward force on the bottle due to water must be balanced, and you have to push the bottle downwards. What I meant to say here, look at the stone, one example of stone and one example of empty bottle. We have two examples. What is happening in these cases? So let us look at this case. Here you can see a body, see a piece of wood. It is floating. Now here you can see the weight acting downward, W. So what is W again equal to for the body? W equal to M into G. What is M equal to? Mass equal to density, D into volume. So the downward force acting on any body is density into volume into G. And the upthrust, okay, but here what is the condition? You can see the W is smaller than the U. You can see the size of the upthrust. The upthrust is more, the W is less. So when the upthrust is more than the weight, the body will float. So this is condition number one. The body will float. Now you can see the W is greater than the U. Here W is greater than U, like for the stone. So weight is more, the body will sink. Can you see? So one condition, W is less than U. Second condition, W is greater than U. There is also one third condition which occurs like this. When the body is just touching the surface of the water, this one. This condition occurs when W equal to U. So the downward and the upward force is equal, the body floats in such a way it just touches the surface. Okay, so see the condition, when W is less than U, the weight is less than the upthrust, the body will float. When the weight is greater than the upthrust, the body will sink. When the weight is just equal to the upthrust, just equal, the body will float with the surface touching. But this body here, you can see this body here has not sunk completely, is not floating completely. This body is in the midway of the water. It is suspended somewhere in between. Now how can a body be suspended? Like if you see mud particles in water, they suspend, they float fully in the water. They are not at the surface, they are not at the bottom. So here you can see very clearly, when the weight is less than the upthrust, it floats. When the weight is greater than the upthrust, it sinks. But how does it remain suspended in the liquid? Suspended. So this is only possible when W equal to U. But if W equal to U, it should float like this. Now, in this case, what has happened is the upthrust, see, the W remains the same, because I told you W equal to M into G, M is not changing. So W remains the same. Okay, but the upthrust I told you is equal to pressure into area. Now this pressure increases with depth. So here the pressure is left, the pressure into A, U is less, here the pressure is increasing. When you reach the area where this U becomes equal to the W, at that point in the water, the body will float. This is the principle of the submarine. This is the exact principle of the submarine. What is the principle? You try to find out from the net the working of the submarine or the structure. The submarine is a huge body like a ship having empty air spaces. When you want the submarine to sink inside the water, you will fill the air spaces with water. When you fill it with water, the weight will increase, the submarine will start to sink. When you want the submarine to go to the surface, you push the water out, again fill it with air, the weight decreases and the submarine will reach the surface. So, these are the laws of flotation. So, what is the, we talked about here, weight and upward force, but I told you what is weight, density into volume into G. What is pressure, H, rho, G. So, if you compare these two, then this volume is gone. So, we have to only compare now the density of the body with the density of the fluid. Only compare density of the body with density of fluid. So, if the density is then less than the liquid. So, if the density of the body is less than density of the fluid, it will float. If the density of the body, D, is greater than the density of the liquid, rho, then it will sink. So now you can just see whether the body will float or sink by comparing their density. So that is all we need to do. And why we are using this word density? Because the liquid can be water, can be kerosene, can be alcohol, and so on. So this is a very, very important thing, the density of the fluid. Now we will think of something else. Okay, before I go to the Archimedes principle, let us discuss density. So you know, when we heat any object, that matter expands on heating. So when you heat a fluid, the molecules go far apart and the density becomes less. Remember, when the molecules go far apart, the density becomes less. Now water is cold at the poles. You know, the water is cold at the poles, very cold, ice cold. And at equator, the water is warm. So, density of water at the poles is greater than density of water at the equator. That is why ships can carry more load at the poles. Density at the poles. Ship can carry more load at the poles because the cold water is giving a much upward force. The density is more. But when the ship is coming towards the equator, if the ship is coming towards the equator, then the density is less, so upward force is less. So you have to download the goods from the ship or the ship might sink. That is one thing. Second, compare fishes living in fresh water and fishes living in the sea. Sea water is salty. You know that? And because of the salt, the density is high. Because the density is high, the pressure is also high. In the river water, there is no salt, density is less. So fishes in the river are almost round in shape, while fishes in the sea are flat in shape. They are flat to withstand the pressure because of the high density of the sea water. Same way, ships which sail in the sea, in the salty water, because of the more density of the salty water, the ships in the sea can carry more weight. But when these ships move in the river, inland in the river, they have to lessen their weight. Because the density is less, the ship might sink. So these are the comparisons in density. So the fish is in the sea. Okay, now there is a place called Dead Sea. It's not actually a sea, it's a lake. Dead Sea is the lake, but it is called the Dead Sea because there is so much salt inside that lake that no living organisms live there. So it is called the Dead Sea. Now the point is, you can easily float on the Dead Sea, read a newspaper, because of the high density, because of the salt, all the bodies will float in. It is impossible to sink in that. Yes, a human body will not sink in the Dead Sea because the density is high. So after the comparison of density, and we talked about the sinking and the floating. So we saw when the W is greater than the U, the W is greater than the U, the body will sink. W less than U, the body will float. Now W is measured by M into G. That is the downward weight, downward. How will we measure the up thrust? So to measure the up thrust, the idea was given by Archimedes. So it is called the Archimedes principle. It is the mathematical way to measure the up thrust. So the question asks here, we have understood what is up thrust. It is the upward force given by the fluid. But what is the magnitude? Is it the same for all fluids? Do all bodies in a given fluid experience the same force? So Archimedes stated the principle, when a body is immersed fully or partially in a fluid, like we saw, very important to see, sometimes the body is partially immersed in the fluid and sometimes the body is fully immersed in the fluid. Yes, so this is very important, you should know. Sometimes the body is partially immersed in a fluid, sometimes it is fully immersed in a fluid. So when a body is immersed fully or partially in a fluid, it experiences an upward force that is equal to the weight of the fluid displaced by it. Look at this. How to measure the upward force? You have to measure the weight of the liquid displaced by it. Weight of the liquid or weight of the fluid displaced. This is the key word. How will you measure the up thrust? It is the weight of the fluid displaced. Means, you can see, there is say water in any part of the earth, any part of the body. When you are going to put the body inside, this body, when you will put it inside, you can see here, in this condition. Yes? In this condition, in the liquid, the whole body is not immersed. Only part of the body is immersed, this much. This is inside the fluid, the rest is outside the fluid. So you can see this one, the volume which is immersed will displace the same amount of volume of the fluid. So this volume, yes, should give us the weight of the fluid displaced. So try to understand how to calculate the up thrust. It is nothing but the weight of the fluid displaced. So the applications are many, designing ships, submarines, lactometers. Lactometers are used to determine the purity of a sample of milk. So remember this one line answer. How to determine the purity of a sample of milk? By a lactometer. And hydrometers are used to determine the density of liquids. So, here we have got a small diagram showing the Archimedes principle. You can see this liquid is filled till this height, till this sprout. This is called a sprout. So, the liquid is filled till this sprout. Now slowly a body is immersed. So when you immerse the body inside, immerse it, you can see this much water is displaced. that water will flow out. When the body fully goes inside, then that much water, see this volume, the volume of the body and the volume of the liquid displaced will remain the same. I hope you follow this. Whatever you put inside the liquid, that much liquid will be displaced, that much liquid will overflow. So, as you put the body inside the liquid, that much volume of the liquid will overflow, this volume. So now you know the volume of the liquid which has been displaced. If you know rho, what is rho? Rho is the density of the liquid. So how do you find the weight of this liquid? It will be m into g. But what is m equal to? Volume into density. So v rho g. So upthrust is given by the formula v rho g. What is v? Volume of the liquid displaced. What is rho? Density of the fluid. And g is acceleration to gravity. So remember, pressure of a liquid is given, or a fluid is given, by h rho g, while upthrust u is given by the formula v rho g, where v is the volume of the fluid displaced, rho is the density of the fluid, and g is acceleration due to gravity. Okay, so now I hope you have understood what is the Archimedes principle. Again we repeat, the upward force acting on a body when it is fully or partially immersed in a fluid. So when a body is fully or partially immersed in a fluid, the upward force acting on the body is equal to weight of the liquid displaced. Okay, so upthrust is given by what? Upthrust is given by weight of the liquid. This is not the weight of the body, this is weight of the fluid which is displaced. Fluid displaced. So now you can understand one very simple phenomenon, why the iron nails sink in water but an iron ship floats on water. Huge ships are built of iron, but why they float in water? Because they are hollow inside. So the very big ship has got a very big mass, has got a very big weight, but when the ship is put into the sea, the ship goes a little inside. So if you look at the ship, it is mostly like this. Part is outside, but a part is inside. So when this ship, part of the ship goes into the sea, this much volume of liquid is displaced. And the volume of the liquid, this volume which is displaced, the density of seawater and g will give us the upthrust. So this will provide the upthrust for the remaining part of the ship to float. So now you understood. So you can try a small experiment at home. Very small experiment to understand the working of the ship. Take a bucket of water and take a steel bow. Take a bucket of water and take a steel bow. Put the steel bowl on the water. You will find the steel bowl will float. Okay, you will see the steel bowl floating in the water in the bucket. Slowly add the water inside the bowl. You will see the bowl slowly starts to go inside, deeper and deeper, because the weight is increasing. When you fill the bowl fully with water, you will find that the bowl sinks to the bottom. So when you fill the bowl with water, you increase the weight, but a bowl filled with air, the weight is less, but it is displaying the same liquid, so it will float. Now since we are done with density, let us talk of relative density. The next topic we have is relative density. Now why we are talking about relative density is because we saw that the bodies sink and float when we compare the density. What is density? Density of a substance we know is the mass per unit volume, okay, or kg per meter cube. So you can write density as kg per meter cube. Sometimes we write it gram per centimeter cube, but these are the SI unit, the standard unit. Okay, now density of a given substance under specified condition remains the same. So density is one of the characteristics property of any material. When we say density of gold is 19,300 kg per meter cube, means if you take a cube of gold, it is a very big cube. You have to take a cube of gold whose breadth is 1 meter, height is 1 meter and length is 1 meter. Then this cube of gold will weigh 19,300 kg. Okay? And if you take water in the same cube, water will weigh 1000 kg per meter cube. Means if you take a cube, 1 meter cube, and fill it with water totally without the weight of the cube, you don't take the weight of the cube, but you just fill water with, the water will be weighing 1000 kg. So that is what means by density. So how to see the purity of a substance? So compare the standard unit. So here our standard unit is water. So when you want to know the relative density, always compare with water, and water at 4 degrees Celsius, remember this. Because it is exactly 1000, we have taken it at 4 degrees Celsius. So now take the density of the substance, find it out, find the density of water and compare. This is called relative density. If it is equal to 1, the body will float on the surface. If it is greater than 1, the body will sink inside. If it is less than 1, the body will float on water. The same condition. See, density of substance, I told you, you can compare with W. And density of water, you can compare with U. Compare. This is not equal, compare. So when W is equal to U, it will be 1 floating on the surface. W greater than U, it will sink. W less than U, yes, it will float, being a little out of the liquid. So the relative density will tell us the ratio of density. We can compare the density with other substances. So now we have got a question here. Relative density of silver is 10.8. Relative density is 10.8. Density of water, again there is a mistake here, this is raised to 3. Density of water, D-alcohol, is 10 raised to 3 kg per meter cube. So, we know the formula, relative density equal to density of silver upon density of water. So, density of silver equal to relative density into density of water equal to 10.8 into 10 raised to 3 equal to 1.08 into 10 raised to 4 kg per meter cube. So here we are going to end the lecture and end the chapter also. Kindly go through all the lectures once again. Try to understand again what is the universal law of gravitation, how it leads to thrust on the surface of the earth, how it leads to pressure. But pressure in fluids and gases is because the particles move in different directions. So liquids extend pressure on the side walls. In the physical application, we see the construction of the dam. Then we learned about buoyancy and the upthrust. So we understood the working of the submarine. Yes? So now we will know all the practical things, why somewhere the areas are increased, in some places the areas are decreased, to make our work easier. So here I am going to end the chapter. Kindly go through it and understand it fully. Thank you.